Yo!
What's up? I'm Adam.
And I'm Kristyna Ferris.
And Kristyna is joining us to talk about legends, because she is a legend. Before we get into it, first off, tell the folks who you are and what you do.
So I'm Kristyna Ferris. I work over at P3 Adaptive as a solution architect. So I like to say I take your data questions and I turn them into business answers.
And Kristyna, you're very active in the community, conferences, social media, blogging, like all the things. And you are an MVP, right?
Yes. Oh, I totally forgot about that. I did not forget about being an MVP. I love being an MVP. It feels like such a big community, and it's just so fun to be a part of. Even if I wasn't an MVP, I would do all the things I do.
Appreciate all of your hard work on that. So why are we talking about legends? Why is it important?
When you're building visualizations, you are trying to tell a story. If you are just putting numbers on a screen, we should have stayed in Excel, right? And I love Excel, for the record. When I look at a report, my goal is to be able to answer at least one question within 3 seconds. And legends can help us get there.
Okay. Kristyna, enough all this talking. You know we like to do it here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to your desktop.
Alrighty. So you can see here, I've got a pretty simple setup. I've just got one slicer on here to start out with. I'm going to pull in a pretty simple line chart to start off with.
So no Copilot for you?
No Copilot yet. I still like a little bit of old school, Adam. And just a couple of call outs on my machine. You'll notice I don't have dark mode on. I find it can be harder, especially if I'm showing other people and then they open their laptop for the first time and it's not in dark mode.
That's a presentation pro tip of typically you don't want to use dark mode when presenting.
100%. I'm going to go ahead and pull in a couple of dimensions. So I've got my dim calendar. I'm going to pull in my calendar date, and I'm going to pull in my sales measure of sales amount. You can see at a glance that I've got a pretty big spike, but what that's doing is it's actually kind of hiding any other trends that might live in here. Because I've got this at a day level, I need to be able to roll this up. The primary way we can do that is by breaking this down with hierarchies and legends. So you might have noticed when I pulled this in, I don't have the default date calendar turned on. If you are opening Power BI for the first time, I'll just show you where that lives. You can go under File and then Options and Settings. And underneath Options, you're going to get quite a few settings in here, but this is the one we're talking about today. This Time Intelligence Auto Date Time for New Files. So if I were to select that, I would get a built-in hierarchy. The reason that people turn this off by default is because Power BI is making tables behind the scenes, and it can drastically slow down your performance. You can see mine is pretty wide. Yeah. I've got quite a few fields in here. The key one we're going to look at is we're going to pull in a couple of things to make our hierarchy, right? So I'm going to start with year, and then I'm going to pull in my quarter, and I'm going to pull in my month. I can now drill up on this visual, and I can see this at a different level. And I'm already seeing better trend lines, right? I can see what's happening. Instead of going down to this day level where things are kind of obfuscated, I now get a much better picture of some seasonal trends. So you might be thinking, well, this is great and all, but I kind of was curious about legends, right?
Right.
So yeah, we're trying to talk about today.
Where are we going?
You're like,
where
are my legends? Yes. What I want to show you next is we're going to put this stuff year over year. So that's the power of legends. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to keep my quarters in there for now, and I'm going to drag year down into my legend field, and I'm going to take it out of my x-axis. When I do that, I now can see year over year at a glance. I want to know at what point did we see a dip in a certain year? This is not linear. This is clearly some seasonal trends going on in Q3 and 4 and 2. But what did I do differently in Q1 of 2024 that caused such a spike that I didn't do in Q1 of 2023? That's one of the big things that I wanted to show you in Legends. Now, if you're going to be doing this sort of thing, my recommended charts for you are going to be the line chart, because it's really clear, right? And then I can also do the same thing with the area chart. I think those two places are going to give you the most bang for your buck with using year over year trends. I can now even go deeper. I can look at a month level. I can see that the biggest difference is actually coming from February, right? Not necessarily just Q1. And if I want to go even further, I can get down to the actual day level. Now, in mine, you notice that it flipped. I don't have that nice little legend anymore. This is something else I wanted to call out, because this is the behavior in your default calendar date hierarchy is going to have this date at the last level. I'm going to get rid of that, and I'm going to populate it instead with day. When I do that, now I can see year over year which day of the year is causing my big spike. Now, obviously, in this case, we've got something called leap year. Leap year is going to add an extra day of revenue that wouldn't have been there in the previous year. So that easily accounts for why that quarter is significantly higher.
So right? A lot of people bought stuff on leap year.
They did. They really did. So we've looked at year in our legend. I'm going to do legend with another dimension. I want to look at my territories and see where I'm selling stuff. So if I go with my region, for example, and I plop that into my legend, I can now see where I'm selling things more often than not. I can see at a glance that the Lorien Forest is buying quite a bit more than even Mordor does or Rohan. Again, chart matters with legends. So if I am looking at this, again, I might want to do a clustered column chart for this one just because I can easily see. And we can go into like auto scaling here. Just wanted to show you there's lots of cool ways to use legends.
You're showing the basic, you know, legend feature that's inside of Power BI. But what about like, are there ways that people can get creative and do like custom legends? Or are you just stuck with the default option?
No, you get lots of options. Power BI every day is coming out with new customizable things, and Legends is one of the most fun. We've got these different options of where the legend lives, the style of the legend. You can even give it, you know, customizable titling. The biggest thing with Legends that makes them dynamic is that they're using columns. If you think about other things that use columns, calculated columns, field parameters. Can you imagine if you had a field parameter that you would use as a legend? That's one of the most fun ways to customize it.
Let us know in the comments below, what are your thoughts on legends? What are some cool things you've done with them? What are the challenges? What do you want to see in Power BI? Like if there's something more that you need that's missing, let us know down below. As always, from Patrick, Martha, myself, and Kristyna, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.